Welcome to another edition of Dizzarian Plays Guild Wars 2. I am on my level 11 Necromancer, Norn, and right where I left off, and I was going through my icons up here, and I was noticing one of these was going off. It was this hero one, and so I looked at it, and I could see here now that the skill training is opened up, and I have 2 points to spend. They've changed this around since the last time I played, so I'm not familiar with this. I assume it's the same thing, but they've made it look more disorganized. I mean, I could see that they've kind of organized things here a little bit better on this. So you see your elite specialization and maybe different minion training, so it's kind of a tree form a little bit, it looks like. I don't know. This looks more complicated than the previous version, if you ask me, but... Anyway, I'm interested in the minions. That's one of the reasons I play Necromancers, is I like minions and pets and that type of thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the minion training and get Summon Blood Fiend. And you can see there, he summon a Blood Fiend that transfers health to you on each attack. So that's definitely gonna be handy. And I can get Summon Bone Minions. And can I train that as well? Yes, I have 7 points altogether. And I can summon a Bone Fiend. Really? I can do all of this at once? Interesting. So I could have 3 pets out right now? Yes. Give it to me. A Shadow Fiend. But he's going to take 4. So let's also see... heal when struck... so this is Vampirism. And, no, because I'm going to have my minion healing me. Well-trained. Conjure a well-blood that heals allies. Spectral training. Pull your foe to you. Chill them. No. Spite. Shroud skill. Curses. Curses are nice. But it doesn't really look like I have enough to train. I guess I do have some of these... skill trainings I can do, but I think I'm gonna leave it at that for right now. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change this to my, I think, mobilizes, summon a bone fiend that attacks foes, delivering cripple attack on every 10th of a second. It doesn't go away. What's the other one I had? Summon bone minions, 2 bone minions. Explode a bone minion, oh right. Okay, so let's call this guy out. So we're now finally getting into Necromancer stuff. So I've got bone minions out, and I've got this. When does this one unlock? 15, so soon I'll be able to fill these out, and I'll have lots of minions, or I hope I can anyway. Let's go ahead and take a look at the scout. This should really up my damage and everything else. This should really make much more better. Much more better. It should make my survivability much better than it was before. Why is this still on? Is it showing me I still have... Yeah, that's fine. Okay, let's see what the scout has to say. Where are we going next?
It's our duty to defend the trade roads to and from Lion's Arch. That's made somewhat difficult when one of our fortress havens is under constant attack by the Sons of Svanir. We've been so busy going on the offensive against Jormag's worshippers that we barely noticed the Char setting up operations in this territory.
Okay, so all of these, I'm just level 11, so all of these seem a little more than I expected. So I got 5 hero points, I guess, for getting level 10. I got hero points, which allowed me to do what we just did, and a utility slot unlocked, which was great. Upcoming rewards, crafting in the next level. Okay, so since those are a little higher level than what I expected, I think what I'm actually going to do, and I'm twirling my mouse to make it zoom in and out like this, I think I'm gonna go ahead and take a look at my stories, the Weapon of Legend. So I'm gonna recall here. Love how quickly it teleports you around. Okay, so I'm back here. And, oops, not that away. I want to go up here to where all the big animals are. And you can still see I've got my bone fiends around, my bone minions. So they're all still following me. And we're going to go up in here, and this is going to be the major Norn city, I believe. Hoelbrak. So we can see there's lots of things to do in Hoelbrak. There's all sorts of undiscovered vistas and waypoints because it's a big area. This is the main Norn location. Where we need to go is here into the Great Lodge to follow my story. I think, we'll probably spend all of the episode in here. I'm going to do a couple of vistas and stuff on this side. I'll probably start here and then just kind of walk in here. I'm not too interested in all the points of interest. Those will come at a later point. But I do like the vistas, so there's one right up there. So I'm going to go ahead and try to capture it. Should be easy enough. I think it just go along the side here. And that way we can have a good look at Hoelbrak, maybe, from this vista. Some of them are a lot more difficult than this. This isn't bad. Definitely looks cold. I wonder how they light those braziers up there. Probably shoot a flaming arrow up there. Oh, that's pretty nice. Nice design on the bridge. Okay, so next up, we're actually going to go into the Great Lodge. So I'm going to go up in here and go into the Great Lodge. See it right there. You can see how large it is. It's one of the another great thing about Guild Wars 2 is the scale of things sometimes is really impressive on how they pull that off. Hit this waypoint as well. So that definitely looks like it's towering. Like how could they have built that by hand? Love that.
Are your hunts dissatisfied? The vigil will take your promise and reforge you into
so I'm showing you because we've not been in here before, and I think it's pretty neat. And you may be from a, you know, if you do play Guild Wars 2, it may be that you're from a different location and you haven't played that much, so you haven't seen all of these other cities. So I definitely want to show those. Okay, it looks like I'm on an upper level, so I'm gonna have to find a way down. You can see on the map here there's these little ramp downs. And it'll actually kind of show you that they are right here. So it's good to look around. Got some flags flying in the breeze. And then here are the doors of the Great Lodge. Look at that. That is so cool. Oh, and I get stuck on a log. 13 or 14. That's how awesome I am. Right. Is there a waypoint in here? Yeah. There it is. Yeah. Okay, they got pictures on the wall. Look at that. Very nice. Still very big on the inside. They're hanging some kind of great big tooth down right there. What the heck was that? Alright, so let's begin our story.
Bygarth the Smith, what would you have of this season's finest slayer?
Oh, you're mighty confident for one so young. Reminds me of me after I won the great hunt. Oh, but that was a long time ago. I chose smithing over hunting, and I never regretted it. Now it's time to forge my masterpiece, a mighty weapon to break Jormag's tooth.
Nothing has so much as scratched the tooth in over 100 years. What makes you think you could craft such a thing?
I guess that's Deldramore the thing that was hanging steel. Down that they're talking about.
If I can get my hands on enough of it, I can make a weapon to shatter mountains. The secret of the alloy was lost with the dwarves, but I can smelt existing relics into the steel I need. Such artifacts have surfaced in a Jotun cave near Grollenfjord.
Grollenfjord.
Yeah, that's why I sent for you. If you can beat back the Jotun and collect the artifacts I need to forge the weapon, You might be worthy of bearing it. Interested?
Sure.
Interesting.
Seems like we're both...
I'm determined.
...benefit from it.
Ready your forge for dwarven metal, smithy.
Awesome. So this is the tooth that they're talking about trying to shatter. I guess it's some kind of Norn tradition that someone who shatters it could rule or something, you know. One of those great Viking myths. Viking-like myths, not actual Viking myths. So, obtain Delmore Steel from the Jotun. And that's not in the city here, of course. That's out here. You can see it's over here where we were in a previous episode. So I think instead of running back through Hoelbrak, let's just go ahead and teleport there. I mean, why not? It's only 15 copper, right? Oh, I want to point out something here that, as you can see, I'm being leveled down right now to level 4. Anytime you're in Guild Wars 2, unless you're like leveling right at your level or anywhere else, depending on the area that you're in, you'll get leveled down to that area. So, yeah. Which I like. I think that's a good idea. But I don't know if that's the case when we enter this instance, so we'll see. Okay. So, it looks like we're definitely going to be killing just... I need to return my minions. Way they can keep me healed. And these little minions you can actually blow up, which is kind of cool. You can blow them up and then have to respawn them. You can blow them up one at a time, I think.
I need help.
This guy, you can sacrifice your blood fiend to heal yourself, so he can be an emergency heal as well. Oh, wait, what's this? So let's see, I'm going to blow up one of our minions here and let's see what happens. Boom! See how he left like a splatter mark there? Blow up the other one. Yeah, you can see I got a cooldown now.
I can take care of myself.
But no big deal.
But there are more prisoners inside. The sun's dragged at me. And then I heard screams. Don't worry about me, help them.
Okay. I didn't even see you there.
Live. We now make another offering. A hunter who wandered too close. He is strong. His sacrifice will gain us power. Couldn't butcher an entire homestead without his
It's kind of loud over the voice. It's kind of like the read that. You can see I am being scaled down to level 10 down here. So, just a little bit more on the skills. These skills here on the left-hand side are determined based on the weapon that you're carrying. So there's nothing, you can't train anything special. It's just based purely on the weapons that you're carrying and using. The right-hand side, though, is based on the skills that you buy. So that was why I was able to buy these minions. And the reason I was going after them. So these guys died, didn't they? Sure did.
Okay. Arise,
strong man, hear us. Give us the strength to reclaim our birthright. Jorman, give us strength.
Jorman, give us strength.
You can see, I can pull off all those AoEs and then switch over to my axe, which is pretty slick. So you can switch back and forth like that really quickly and get the stuff that you need. Retrieve the artifacts. Yes. And this looks like some kind of... This crude shrine appears to be dedicated to the Elder Dragon Jormag. A recently deceased Norn is splayed across the altar. Spit on the shrine. Your spit freezes in the air and shatters upon the cold stone of the altar. I'll leave the shrine. Okay, so I guess that's it. Yeah, because this... Alright, return to Hoelbrak. So let me do that now. Alright, so I'm back into the hall, and
I tried breaking
now, let's give him, see what happens. What's a box in every of fun? Generation,
and I'm afraid I lost.
Silence then.
I'll speak to Newt Whitebear for you.
That's kind of funny.
Tell him my people no longer keep us busy.
There's something else going on there.
I brought your dwarven steel, blacksmith. I also saw the bodies of the other hunters you sent. Those Jotun are worshipping the ice dragon.
Bear's breath. I didn't know that. I'll take the steel off your hands, but I can't do anything about the Jotun. Though I do know someone who can. Do you know Erstegalkin?
Erstegalkin?
Beautiful. Travels with a huge black wolf. She killed one of the Ice Dragon's strongest lieutenants.
Of course, she fought beside me against Isormir. And I've heard songs of her epic deeds at several moots.
She could help us. And not to be a gossip or anything. I hear she's taken quite an interest in you since the Great Hunt.
Well.
In me?
Yeah,
why?
Of course me.
To tell you the truth, I'm not sure. Perhaps you impressed her. In any case... ask her about these Jotun, and I'm sure she'll lend a hand.
Excellent.
If you want to hear more, talk to me. I have many
right,
tales
so,
to tell about the world.
Where is she
was
at?
In ancient times.
Ah, she's just right up over here. We're gonna travel to the western point. Eastern point, whatever it said. And... see what she has to say. See how taken she is with me. Kid, dog. Yes, enter it. Ooh, look at her there. Okay, so you can see this kind of put us in a small instance, and there's actually a point of interest in this. It happens here in some of the cities where you can't reach a point of interest if you're trying to be a completionist, unless you actually do
oh,
the storyline, because then
you
you'll
know
be allowed
into
it.
I can't carve your image properly when you're wiggling. Ugh, this stone isn't right. It'll never... what's that, Garm? Someone's coming?
Very
yeah,
me.
Well, we'll leave this alone for now. Perhaps the next stone will be better.
All right. See what she has to say.
It's good to see you again, Slayer. You look troubled. What's wrong?
I've been to the Jotun caves near Gralenfjord. They're worshipping the Elder Dragon Jormag.
Jotun are fanatical about their old ways. They wouldn't worship Jormag. Unless, what do you know about the Sons of Svanir?
That they're paying.
I know they're the idiots who embrace the Ice Dragon as a spirit of the wild.
From what you saw, so do these Jotun. There has to be a connection. There are Sons of Svanir near Hirbat's camp. They might be involved. This is definitely worth a Slayer's attention. If you're willing, Garm and I will meet you there. Let's see if we can persuade the Sons to tell us what's going on.
Very
that
well.
That sounds perfect. Erstegalkin, side by side with the Slayer of Isormir. The Skalds will sing of this for generations.
Careful. Skalds also sing of noble hunters dying grisly deaths. But with Wolf's help, we'll give them something better. See you there.
She's awfully proud of her wolf. Ah, that was the completion of the first part of that. A weapon of legend completed. We need to select our reward. Let's see, toughness, vitality, power. Probably power, right? I don't even know what I should do. Maybe vitality? Maybe vitality. Velvet gloves, linen gloves. Let's do the velvet. I'm just not for sure. There we go. And, yeah. Actually, I think I'm going to go ahead and wrap this episode up. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. In the next episode, we're going to go on. I think this is still, yeah, it's still level 10. So probably going to go on to the next level, into the next episode. We'll continue to do this. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. It helps me out so much when you guys subscribe, and I really do appreciate it. So, till next time, bye.